So friends, a variety of methodologies for assessing risk are available, and some are more complex than others. Whichever approach is used, the outcome should be similar. The choice of methodologies, unless mandated by management or a regular bodies, should be based on best fit for the organization. This may include using COVID-5 approach to risk assessment, including identification, analysis, and evaluation. No single best approach to the selection of methodology for conducting a risk assessment exists. However, the result may meet the goal and objective of the organization in identifying the relative risk rating of asset and process at criticality to the business. It is also essential to identify as much as significant risk as possible. Hi, I am Shailendra Srivastava, and I would like to welcome you all in today's session of Information Risk Management, which is a part of our cybersecurity exam, especially for those aspirants who are preparing for CISM or C-Risk. In this session, we will be covering extensively risk assessment, risk identification, risk analysis, risk evaluation. We'll also go through some basic definition of what is all about malware, understanding attackers, social engineering attacks, and I also give some advices for the exam. Some or full content of this session may help you to be a cyber aware and also help you to understand the security concepts while preparing for, as I said, security exam like CISM or C-Risk. In CISM, this will cover under domain 2, which is information risk management. In C-Risk, domain 1, which is IT risk management, and domain 2, which is IT risk assessment. Friends, most risk assessment approach have 3 phases. Each is discussed in detail in subsequent session of this session. This includes risk identification, risk analysis, risk evaluation. Risk identification is the process of using risk scenario to determine the range and nature of risk to the organization. Risk analysis is the process of combining the vulnerability information gathering during an assessment and the threat information gathered from other source to determine risk of compromise, both in terms of frequency and potential magnitude. Analysis may include statistical computation such as value at risk, which is VAR, ALE, annual loss of expectancy, or ROSI, return on security investment. To gain greater insight into risk distribution, that is maximum risk and probable risk and potential consequences, and that we called as an attack. Impact. Risk evaluation. Risk evaluation is a process of comparing the result of the risk analysis against established criteria for acceptability, impact, likelihood, and the need for further treatment. Deciding whether risk treatment is required is usually based on operational, technical, financial, regulatory, legal, social, or environmental criteria, or combination of these criteria. The criteria should be in line with the scope and support of organization's goal and objective. Let's dig further down on risk assessment. Risks are everywhere in the world of the information security, from hackers and malware to lost device and missing security patches. There is a lot on the plate of information security professional. Of course, addressing each one of these risks take both time and money. Therefore, information security professionals need to prioritize their risk list in order to spend these precious resources where they will have the greatest security effect. That's where risk assessment comes into play. Risk assessment is the process of identifying and tracing the risk facing an organization based upon likelihood of their occurrence and the expected impact they will have on the organization's operation. We need to have a common language around risk. In everyday life, people often use the term threat, risk, and vulnerabilities interchangeably. They are actually three different concepts. Threat is some external force that jeopardizes the security of your information and system. Threat might be naturally occurring, such as hurricanes and wildfires, and man-made also, such as hacking and terrorism. You cannot normally control what threats are out there. They exist independently. The risk assessment approach developed by NIST is mentioned in NIST Special Publication 800-30 Revision 1. There is one related term that you should know for the exam. A threat vector is a method that an attacker used to get to a target. This might be a hacker toolkit, social engineering, physical intrusion, or any other number of other hacking technique. Risk identification is a process by which the type and nature of threat are determined and the organization's vulnerabilities that are subject to those threats are examined. Vulnerabilities are weaknesses in our security controls that a threat might exploit to undermine the confidentiality, integrity, and the availability of your information or system. These might include missing patches, promising firewall rule, or other security misconfiguration. You do have control over the vulnerabilities in your environment, and security professionals spend much of their time hunting down and remediating vulnerabilities. Risks occur when your environment contains both a vulnerability and corresponding threat that might exploit that vulnerability. For example, if you haven't updated your antivirus signature recently and a hacker release a new virus on the internet, you face a risk. You are vulnerable because you are missing a security controls and there is a threat, the new virus. There is no risk if either the threat or vulnerability factor is missing. For example, if you live in an area far from the coast, it doesn't matter if your building is vulnerable to hurricanes because there is no threat of hurricanes in your region. Similarly, if you store your backup tapes in a fireproof box, there is no risk from building fire because your storage container is not vulnerable to fire. Once you have identified the risk facing your organization, you probably still have somewhat overwhelming list. The next stage is the risk assessment process rank. Those rank by two factor, likelihood and impact. The likelihood of a risk is the probability that it will actually occur. For example, there is a risk of earthquake in both California and Wisconsin. When you look at the data, however, you find that the probability of an earthquake occurring is far higher in California, where almost 5,000 significant earthquakes occur over the last 25 years. During that same time, Wisconsin didn't experience a single major earthquake. Therefore, security professional in California must be consider about the risk of earthquake, while those in Wisconsin can probably ignore it. The impact of a risk is the amount of damage that will occur if risk materializes. For example, an earthquake might cause severe damage to the data center, while a rainstorm might not cause any damage at all. When we go about performing risk assessment, we have two different categories of technique that we can use to assess the likelihood and impact.